Hello and welcome to Red Stapler channel. In this episode, we'll continue from the previous example and going to add a new button to send a small amount of Ethereum to any wallet, which could be useful for accepting tips and donation on website. Again, we will be using the latest version of MetaMask JavaScript API. Ready? Let's check it out. So here is the example from previous tutorial video that we already added the Connect Wallet button. If you haven't watched it already, you can find the link at the description box below. Now I already added a new button which we will be adding code to request the transfer of a small amount of Ethereum to another wallet. Okay, let's start working. First, let's add the click event to the send tips button. And next, we'll need to create the transaction parameter. The first one will be 2, which should contain the value of the address we want to send the ETH to. And the next one is from, which should be the current connected account address on the MetaMask. I will use the global variable that I created on previous example that contained the address we got from MetaMask. And the last one is value, which is the amount we'd like to send. Now it's a bit tricky since we need to convert the amount to hex number in VAE unit. Here's the example. If I want to send a 0.001 ETH, I will copy the VAE amount and convert it to hex. And then paste it in our code. And next, we will use ethereum.request with sendTransaction method and pass our transaction parameters and then log our transaction hash on the console. Looks good. Now we've got the hash. Next, we'll need to check the transaction confirmation. I will create a new function called checkTransactionConfirmation, which receives the transaction hash. Then I will create another function, which will be used for a recursive loop to wait for a confirmation. This function will return promise from Ethereum request that use getTransactionReceipt. And pass our transaction hash as a parameter. So if the function returns the receipt, which is not null, then we end the recursive call and return the word confirm. But if it's null, then we will call itself recursively. Finally, pass the return promise back to the caller. Then we will call the function after we got the hash after signing the transaction. And pop up the alert box with return value, which should be the confirmed string returned from the recursive call. Okay, let's see the result. Now we've got the hash. Let's wait for the confirmation. Looks good. Our transaction has been confirmed on blockchain. Please note that to prevent the transaction being used on the wrong chain, you need to check the network version or chain ID. For example, the mainnet is 1 and Optimism is 10. So now you have the basic concept on how to send a transaction on MetaMask with JavaScript. You can find the link to the code at description box below. And that's all for this episode. If this video helps you, don't forget to like or subscribe our channel. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Bye.